IVM.
All right, hello, welcome to Football Portal. My name is Saru, and we have a special guest with us. The man, Tanuj Baru, is here. What's up, Baru?
Hello, hello, hello. Let's go.
And we have regular dal roti sabji. Yes, Sawan.
What's up?
Guys,
that is also what he feeds his cat.
That's what Simba eats. All right, 2021 is ending and there's so many matches being cancelled. Let's not even talk about the matches. Let's talk about the year in general and see what's going on. Let's do some best of the year awards.
Baru, everyone does the best of the year awards, man.
So let's do best and the worst, no?
What's stopping us? We should do normal things that happen in the year awards.
Okay, we'll do that as well. So let me see if I can get some questions going. All right, so the first question, yes, is a question which you suggested. So I hope you have an answer. The best player of 2021 in international qualifiers, but the player should have failed in club football.
Oh God. I can only think of Cristiano Ronaldo.
Actually,
he's the opposite of that. Who's the best player? Oh, it's actually Haaland.
Erling Haaland. No. How did he fail?
So again, he's the opposite. Yeah.
Dude.
I suggested this, but I think I'm going to go with Mitrović.
Isn't it Fred?
Fine. So let me take this. Yes, says Mitrović, which kind of makes sense because he scored the goal to kick Portugal to some random qualifier in which they lose to Italy eventually. Mm. And Mitrović, like no one really cares for championship football. So that's a good answer.
Yeah.
Fred Baru, another good choice. I mean, we don't watch football at all anymore, but we still know the right answers.
Because yeah, I mean, we get the athletic notifications, right? So we know what the Brazilian press is talking about.
Fred the Pastor.
Yes.
And then he scored a goal which even Neymar applauded. So, yeah. And my answer would be, my choice for that question would be Raheem Sterling. Guys. Aww. He played so well for England. Wasn't he their player of the tournament till the final or something?
Yeah, he scored a couple of goals. No?
Yes, yeah. But we don't really see much at Manchester City. So, yeah. So, he should move
to Newcastle.
No. Oh, yeah, actually, not be bad. As long as he's not taking St. Maximus' place, I think Sterling should do well at Newcastle.
That's true.
All right. So, let's start with this. Yes, you also suggested a few generic questions. The best manager of 2021.
It's Roberto Mancini for the incredible football that he played in the Euros, which was the better international tournament this year as compared to either the Copa or the Nations League Cup or whatever it's called.
Hmm.
And it's a tournament they won. They were not favorites for it at all. The French were a much better team. In fact, I could pick maybe half a dozen teams that on paper look better than them. But for Italy to play so well, to entertain all of us and to win that competition, it was fantastic.
Yeah, my choice is Thomas Tuchel. I mean, come on, that was an amazing thing, whatever he's done with Chelsea. And we somehow miraculously beat City in the final to get the Champions League. And yeah, he's doing well in the league. So he is like, Baru, what's your choice? Let it be Mikel Arteta.
My answer, same, nothing different.
Same, nothing different. All right.
Yeah.
The worst PSG player of 2021. Baru, why don't we start with you?
I was going to say Ramos, but he hasn't played. So is he a player or something? I
mean, he played one game and got COVID.
Oh, then it counts. Let's go with Ramos.
Why do you think Ramos, has he lost interest in football?
I don't think so. He does pretty well in training.
So why is he not even playing? Why is he the worst PSG player then?
Yeah, because he's not playing, no?
He's so bad.
See, we are not the experts over here, okay? I mean, the manager obviously is.
Okay. Yes, do you have the worst PSG player of 2021?
Is Eric Choupo-Moting still there? Even if he was there for half a season, it should be him. Unless he's tricked some other club to pay him a big fee and a big transfer fee.
Maxim Choupo-Moting, but don't you feel a little like you're choosing Choupo-Moting as an easy option, right? There's Icardi also.
But keeping up with the Icardi, I mean, just keeping him up.
I even forgot Icardi was there.
See,
promoting is just
is good. So we should keep. My answer is simple, guys. Lionel Messi. Like, where the fuck are those goals?
You came up with this question just to, you know, say something scandalous like that.
How is it scandalous? He's not living up to any sort of potential. He's become the Anthony Martial of PSG.
Like, yeah, he even scored against City, which Martial usually does.
Oh yeah, one of the games we saw together, that was a game. But yeah, okay. The best Premier League player of 2021.
So that answer is, it has to be. I mean, the serious answer has to be Salah, because people forget how underwhelming he was actually in 2020. I mean, Liverpool won the title and all, but his good performance were in the first half of the season.
Salah
massively improved in 2021.
But was he actually that underwhelming? Didn't he score like 28, 29 goals even last year?
No, I don't know about the calendar year. I mean, of course, he was a crucial part of their title.
That was 2 years ago.
Thing. Yeah, but yeah, that's two seasons ago. The year encompasses both seasons. Right?
So, I see. Yeah. So yeah, but Salah is good. Baru, do you concur?
Yeah, of course. I think... But I'd just like to say that Lewandowski was so good in 2021 that even in EPL, he's the best player. So
he was so good.
His greatness surpasses national boundaries. Oh, and arbitrary like ones.
Punchy,
yeah.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Pawan and...
Pawan?
No. What's that song from Refugee?
Punchy.
Pawan ke joke.
Lewandowski is Abhishek Bachchan.
Next time we see Lewandowski in the stadium, he just going to start singing.
No one would even understand. Even the Indian fans, one extra brown guy would be like,
maybe the Iranians will like do us one in reverse or something. It'd be like, you know, let's just chant with them. It must be like a Polish song or something in the Polish ghettos of India.
In Pondicherry.
Oh, shit. How many nationalities were there in Pondicherry, man? Like, oh, is this what the spirit of Auroville is all about?
Oh, yeah. Now they're driving a road through Auroville or something. They had some French Indian guy wearing a lungi standing up to a road roller. So, yeah. But even my answer would probably be Salah. I think he's so good that PSG will buy him next year.
Fingers crossed.
Fingers crossed. Okay.
But he'll still not make the top three in the Ballon d'Or.
Oh, man, yeah. It'll be probably.
We'll have to wait for Egypt to win the World Cup and, I don't know, something.
What if Ballon d'Or is during Ramadan? You think he can go up and accept the award?
Yeah, as long as they're not spraying champagne on him, so.
I don't think they do, so.
Do they still serve Ruafza in the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix?
Yes, sure. That's what the sheiks are having.
Ferrari Ruafza.
All right. Okay, let's move on. We have to keep this moving on. Yeah. Best CFL. Yes, please expand CFL first before you blurt out your answer.
Once again, for the fans out there, is CFL stands for Confirmed Future Legend, which is a player who has the hype he needs but not the hype he deserves.
Correct. So, who was the best CFL of 2021?
Oh man, it has to be one of the Arsenal lads. I mean, there is a lot.
You need
of
to name one. You can't say Arsenal lads.
No, but there's such a plethora of good options. But I'm gonna go with Emil Smith Rowe, or as he's known on our WhatsApp groups, the next Burkham.
What? Wait, who's calling him the next Burkham?
Not Kumar for sure.
So is Emil Smith? But is Emil Smith Rowe that good?
He's okay, man. I mean,
no, like, is he that hype?
No.
Okay.
No. It's not the next Dennis Bergkamp for sure. I mean,
no, is club fans hedging his bets. He knows, look at his face. He thinks Emil Smith Rowe is the next big thing.
No, but then he fits the definition. Right? He doesn't have the hype he deserves.
See, okay, you know, I'd probably say that he's the next Bergkamp if he does all those scuffed shots on purpose, which end up at the back of the goal, because that would be like genius.
Yeah.
Okay. If I hit a shot, then it would be like someone who hits it, save it. But scuff karunga shot, toh, it's a half dummy. Mm. Okay, so you can't really predict the trajectory of that ball.
Right.
So, yeah. But my answer for CFL of 2021 would be if he still counts. I think Rhys James, how old is he now?
There's no age limit till they fail.
And this is probably the first year we haven't even spoken about Jesse Lingard in this category.
I think he hasn't played, dude. That's the problem.
Yeah. So Rhys
Sawala khel raha tha West Ham.
Yeah, but Rhys James is good, dude. He is.
Are you saying that we have to remove the F from the CFL for him?
I mean, just wait till like May, till Chelsea win the league, and then I mean, he's already he'll become a legend. We don't need all this F, L, and all. Yeah. I wanted to say Dean Henderson, but poor guy, he hasn't played at all this season. Because I remember last season, Manchester United fans were like, who needs David De Gea? He can f*** to Madrid. We have Dean Henderson. De Gea ke game mein mistakes aa gaya and all that crap. Poor guy, Dean Henderson. Like, I can't even... If he's played even one game, we could have called him a CFL.
The problem is that the worse United play, the performances of De Gea improve. So he becomes undroppable. Right?
That was, I think, evident in last week. But I think that was more about Sam Maximi not finishing his chances and shooting right at De Gea. De Gea made, I think, one really good save, but he had seven saves or six saves just
fun
handed to him. So that was there.
Yeah,
but there was CFL in the other side that United faced, who always wakes up when they face United, or at least one of the brothers does. Matty Shortstaff was playing, right? Or was it the other one?
Longstaff.
Longstaff, sorry.
Shortstaff. The staff.
If he was a CL, really then we'd like give him the long stuff. Now he's still a short.
Yeah, he always plays well only against United.
Or at least one of the brothers does. I'm not sure if it's him or the other one.
Yeah, the family is a CFL family. The bucket of staff. Oh, man. All right. The worst team of the year. Like, just shambolic. I'll go first. Newcastle Barca. United. No, I want yes to say Barca. I'm giving out yes. But Newcastle United, dude. Mike Ashley left. Like, he just gave basic maintenance money. I don't think he's even paid for health insurance. That club. He's in such doldrums. Even the owners are like, what the f*** are we doing here? It's that bad. I don't know. I mean, they got Eddie Howe because they're like, we have one eye on relegation. Like, what the f***? The richest club in the world is talking like this. Yeah, it's quite dire. So I would say Newcastle.
And I think this just lends more, you know, authenticity to our podcast that we are dissing our own club.
Yes, that's true.
Yeah,
we are genuine fans.
Of course,
I'm tired of it, blood.
Yes. Why is Barcelona the worst club of 2021?
Because Lionel Messi dragged them to the third spot in a sort of pseudo semi-farmers league and they gave him a Ballon d'Or. So imagine how bad they are.
What? You can't blame Barcelona for that.
No, they are so bad that, you know, it was such a big achievement to drag them there. Right? I mean, we don't even have to talk about how shambolic their finances or whatever. I mean, literally, when I read about them, they sound
that
like
they makes sense.
They sound someone, like, yeah, they, no, no. Okay, yeah, go ahead.
Someone got Ballon d'Or for dragging their club to third position in a two-horse race.
Saru, the more you repeat it, the more you understand why he won that Ballon d'Or. This is that good, man.
They had to create award for Lewandowski. Just to appreciate Barcelona finishing third.
They'll have to retire the Ballon d'Or. They're like, nothing can match this one. Ever.
You think Messi's book would read, yes, his autobiography. Yeah. That is the best achievement of my career.
100%. I mean, he'll also say how he was conned as an 11-year-old. He was told that this is the best club in the world, but it turned out to be some sort of a Ponzi scheme.
It turned out to be more than a club.
Yeah, they gave him growth hormone injections. He still didn't grow tall. He's short.
Aray, but daadi to aagi na. We saw that last season.
Yeah. He was a 15-year-old with Afridi beard running around. And 20 years later, he brings them down and wins the Ballon d'Or.
But yeah, and so much of their news, about their finances or all sounds so much like a banana republic.
Yeah.
They had, I mean, the incomes didn't match. Some dictator just took out money, took they out bought bad the loans. Poor,
but they can't register him.
Yeah.
They bought Ruben Diaz. Now they have to sell someone. Otherwise, he'll be just wasted. So now they're begging around, please.
Ferran Torres they bought.
Ferran Torres.
Ferran Torres.
They wish they bought Ruben Diaz.
Yeah. Sorry. Yeah, it doesn't matter. Ferran Torres.
But knowing Barca, they probably thought that they were buying Diaz.
Oh, man. Okay. Baru, can you top that? Which is the worst club of 2021 for you?
Oh, man. I think you've already covered the best two spots. Barca was my first guess, but since that's taken, let's just give it to East Bengal because of the continued season. I mean, there've been two seasons we've covered in 2021 now. One is ongoing, one just got done and just so bad. And this is a club that really fought for sponsors, fought till the last minute for even this season, Sri Cement was supposed to back off at the last minute and like not give them the guarantee of the entry, the franchisee fees and all. But wo sab lad jhagad ke fir again they're back to the same position. So yeah, I think I'll give it to East Bengal then.
Did they fight the sponsors also, East Bengal? Like, nahi chahiye aapke paas.
Haan, wo to hota hai. Like, I mean, that's what the fans do, right? Of these clubs. I cannot describe these clubs. But yeah, I mean, the ATK holding company bought Mohan Bagan. So Mohan Bagan got fans got pissed ki nahi chahiye, you're destroying our identity. Especially the washing machine ad where the Mohan Bagan jersey and the ATK jersey get washed together and it comes out as one jersey.
Of ATK, right?
Of ATK Mohan Bagan.
Dude, Baru is so happy with his answer. He's just frozen. All right. So those are the three worst clubs. We'll keep this. We'll continue this. And there are a few more questions. So stay tuned to Football Twaddle.
Have you ever wondered where the business world is headed? How the ways in which we create, market and sell to consumers will evolve? Or if we'll ever go back to wearing pants while working? For answers to all of this and more, tune into Advertising is Dead with me, Varun Dugirala. Every Tuesday, as I talk to entrepreneurs, leaders and change makers from across business, media, marketing and beyond. You can catch all episodes of Advertising is Dead on the IBM Podcast website, app or wherever you get your podcasts from.
Welcome back to Football Portal. If the first half was looking back at 2021, let's look forward, look ahead. 2022, what's in store for us? Yes, one prediction of 2022, like, you know, a surprise one, a shocking thing that
matches
may happen.
Will get cancelled in January.
Abe, that is not shocking. I'm talking about something that will, like, you know, genuinely shock the world.
Oh, Winter World Cup, right? So I'll pick an unlikely winner. I think Japan will win the World Cup.
Yes. That is so shocking. It doesn't matter. They'll win.
Of course they did. Rest of Asia is not very good.
Japan is going to win the World Cup. Yes. Baru, one unexpected result of 2022.
Somebody deserving would win the Ballon d'Or.
What? They're getting Barcelona to third again?
Memphis Depay.
Memphis. Like Usmana Dembele. Yes. That's the name to it.
Isn't Depay also one of the answers for the first question that Yash asked? Great on the international level, but invisible and like...
Depay had an amazing season with Lyon. He's just like, but now he's dragging Barcelona. The weight is on his shoulders. So, okay, let's give a name. No, like name. I think Dembele will win the Ballon d'Or.
On crutches.
Yes.
So you're just playing the odds, dude. There are so many Dembeles around that mathematically one of them might win.
Musa will win the Ballon d'Or.
The sings of the Indian hockey team.
There are not many, by the way. There are only two, I think, now in the Indian hockey team.
So yeah. He's including the middle name for the
Oh, you mean these Biharis and UPs, the Singhs there?
Yeah. Honorific.
Okay. My prediction is going to be Newcastle is going to win
the championship.
No, that is not for
two. That's not possible.
That's 2023. I think. Newcastle will win the FA Cup. Are they still in the FA Cup?
Of course, we haven't started yet.
What?
Yeah, FA Cup hasn't started.
Are you sure? Let me check.
अरे इट ऑलवेज स्टार्ट्स इन जैन ब्रो इट्स लाइक द न्यू ईयर टेस्ट इट्स लाइक
द फोर्थ राउंड
सिडनी टेस्ट एंड एफए कप स्टार्ट एट द सेम टाइम
Yes, they are playing Cambridge United on Jan 8th. So, yes.
playing a university team.
and I hope Jonjo Shelvey doesn't get a red card. But they're going to win the FA Cup. That is my prediction for 2020.
With a Shelvey screamer in the finals.
Yeah, in the extra time, 119th minute.
Yeah.
With a new manager, Ralf Rangnick. All right. That is for like one expect.
Are they going to change the name of his tech? You know, his tactics. Then instead of like, it's going to be like Jonjo pressing or something.
Jonjo pressing.
Jonjo pressing.
yes. Why not? If he's winning the FA Cup, you can name whatever, right? Okay. One. Who's going to be the standout player of 2022?
Shelby.
That we've already discussed. Now we need like some real names.
I think it depends on where Haaland will go. Actually, this season, and I think he's going to stand out of the dressing room because he won't fit in.
He's so tall, he has to stand out. But yeah, Haaland is good answer. Yes,
I'm going to go with Vinicius Jr.
Oh, dude,
because... but it's 2022, we can call him
senior now.
Yes,
he's a father now.
Of 7 kids, isn't he like?
Oh God!
Was that dude. That was Vinicius only, right? Like he had like 3 kids when he was 19 or something.
So that was Raheem Sterling, dude.
No, like the new.
Achha, the new Sterling.
Generation. Even the new generation has a Sterling.
But no, he's been good this season. I think Brazil deserves another great player. It's been too long. Neymar was a decade back. So
yeah. Okay, Vinicius. Who would I pick as the standout player of 2022? Barella. Yeah, he's having a bit of tough time, but there are rumors that one of the Manchester clubs are eyeing him. Let's see where that goes. But yeah, he probably will do well. Oh, or I think Nicolo Zaniolo. Oh, he is so good.
Where's he from?
Huh? He plays for Roma. Poor guy had 2 ACL injuries, but otherwise he's probably like the best thing to come out of Italy in the last 4-5 years.
2 ACL injuries.
Huh?
So 2 ACL injuries. So he's definitely going to fight with Delis. For the Ballon d'Or then.
yes. It's like he and the Dembele's. But dragging Barca to third is a bigger achievement than anything in world football.
Ever. So,
all right. One manager who is going to shine in 2022. Yash.
Man, Julian Nagelsmann.
It's such a safe answer. Obviously, he'll win like some, like say everything with Bayern. Okay, fine, whatever. Your answer is your answer, not my answer. Baru?
I have a safer answer. Guardiola.
Are you sure? If he's
How
not
much win... more will he shine, dude? That yeah. ball
but if he doesn't win the
Champions League,
if he doesn't win the Champions League, I don't think he's going to shine. No one really cares if he wins the Premier League, so.
Shining is shining, man. Ask Arteta.
No.
Was he the shine boy?
Yeah. Is Arteta that his job? Paint dal ke aaya tha fourth match mein.
Okay. I don't know who to pick. I'm thinking Roberto Martinez or Mikel Arteta. One of these two is going to do great things. And they're on the cusp of doing great things and resigning. So I don't know which one to go. So one of these two will be the standout manager of 2022. All right. The club, the last question in this series, the clubs to implode. Which club will implode the most in 2022? Oh, like God. Everything is going to go to dogs. We can't say Barcelona.
We
can't say Barcelona.
Yeah, they're already there.
Yeah.
So, and we can't even say Newcastle because that'll just be xenophobic. So.
Yes. So,
okay. I'll say Chelsea.
How? You have to explain how as well.
No, it's their threshold of imploding or being in a crisis is very low. So, if they don't win stuff and...
That is regular club operations. That's not really imploding.
Okay.
Like Chelsea is used to firing managers every year, right? So, you can't call it imploding. They just fire everyone every year.
Whichever club is there, I don't think... I mean, the expectations are so standard the way the seasons are going. So I don't know.
You stumped Yash with the question. Baru, do you have an answer?
I'll go with United. I don't think Ralf is going to last long.
Yeah.
So they're going to get into that phase where they start firing managers quicker and quicker.
I have a feeling too that 2022 will be the year United is going to implode and all it will take is Mino Raiola to give one interview and it will start. and Ralph will go, Pogba will go, Martial will want to go.
Ralph is anyways till the end of the season.
I know.
It's about who he picks.
I don't think it'll come to that also. I have a feeling things are going to go really bad. Yeah, so why not? I think United is a good answer. And it's about time also, no, Baruch? Like, enough of this crap.
Yeah, man. Arsenal ka implosion to ho gaya. I mean,
yeah.
Their body bounced back also.
That is implosion.
Until the next Liverpool game.
All right. Let's look a little forward to this weekend. There are going to be some games, I'm assuming. So, there are games on the 1st of Jan, right? 1st and 2nd.
Yes.
All right. Yes, what are you going to watch?
I'm going to watch United versus Burnley.
That is today, tomorrow. The weekend United are going to play Wolves.
No, that is not really a great game. What else is there, man?
There's Chelsea-Liverpool. There's Arsenal-Manchester City.
I leave that for you. As Arsenal-Manchester City. Yeah, I mean, no.
Is it going to be a 7-0 for City or a 1-0 smash and grab for Arsenal?
I think 1-0 smash and grab for Arteta.
Oh, Baru, you're on mute. Yes.
I don't know, man. What fixtures are that like?
I'm helping you. So, yes, picked Arsenal versus City. And he thinks it's going to be a 1-0 smash and grab for the Arsenal.
Okay. What is the London derby of the week, man?
All right.
I haven't asked this question in over a month now.
Watford Tottenham.
Yep, that's the one I'll be watching.
Oh God, Conte is going to win. That guy is such a... I hope...
There's only one London derby this week.
No, this...
Crystal Palace West Ham. Oh, yeah. Crystal Palace West Ham. Yeah,
I'll go for that then.
Okay.
You need to see Kane's face.
Yes, you need to... you need to predict the score also for that.
3-0 to West Ham.
Oh.
Well, let's just go with 2-0 to West Ham because it's 2 is the count of cojones.
I see. And you also want like Vieira to manage Arsenal after Arteta like loses his job. So you don't want him to have bad results. We get it. Yes. I'm going to go with the German morning manager's derby.
Doesn't Vieira have COVID or something? So he won't be like... Or wait, Arteta's got COVID.
Arteta has... I don't know if he has COVID. I just read somewhere he's going to sit out the game for today or something. So is that COVID?
Yeah, I read it somewhere. He's COVID positive.
Is Arteta like one of those employees of corporate? Every wave he has COVID. Isn't this like the third time he's getting COVID or something?
I have no idea, man.
I think he's just making up crap for holidays.
Every variant he just like tested.
He's such
a guinea pig. What's
new, bro?
He's such a hands-on manager. Yeah, I'm going to watch Chelsea versus Liverpool. Even though our good friend Archie wants me to put money on Liverpool, I think it's going to be a
Guda Jigra.
Yes, it's going to be a 2-0 Chelsea victory with two classic goals from Jorginho and
penalties.
Yeah, one on the left corner and the second on the right corner, bamboozling Alisson. And yeah, so that's my prediction. Alrighty, boys, this has been an eventful year.
Yep.
See you guys in 2022.
Goodbye.
Right. Wish you a very happy new year 2022.
Happy new year, everyone.
Please be home and don't go anywhere because we have to meet. And if you guys do such things, it's not going to look good.
All right, then. Later, guys.
Okay, bye bye. Take care.
Hey everybody, it's been another great week on the IVM Podcast Network. On Advertising is Dead, Varun talks to Yan Liu and Shikhar Chaudhary about the halo effect around the IPL on Star Sports and its impact in the overall content industry. Speaking of Varun, on Think Fast with Varun and Suchita, we meet Sajith Pai, director of Bloom Ventures, who gives us an overview of venture capital and funding in 2021. On Ikka Dukka Economy, Abhinav Trivedi and Dr. Bharat Jhunjhunwala discuss the GDP and its effects on our daily lives. On Say No to Drama, Chetna busts all the hype around year endings and New Year resolutions. And on Simplified, the gang gets together to discuss the creator economy and everything it entails. Do follow us on social media. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn. And remember, if you're enjoying this show or any of our other shows for that matter, please do tell a friend. We'd also really appreciate any ratings or reviews you can give us on any of the platforms that we're listening on, whether it's Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or IVM Podcast app. Whatever you're listening, do let us know that that you are listening. I'd also like to remind you all that we have a number of YouTube channels where a number of shows are available. You can go to ivmpodcast.com/YouTube to check out what channels we have. And finally, we'd like to thank our sponsors this week, Cred, Bank of Baroda, CoinSwitch, Kuber, and Intel. Thank you so much for making this possible.
Namaste, this is Cyrus Brocha. I am part of the government cancel culture program to remove rubbish off all the different streams available. So what we have is all the collected rubbish we put together on our show. It's called Cyrus Says. It's on IVM Podcast. You have to watch it and listen to it. It's on our app. It's on our website. It's on the YouTube channel. It's on Facebook. There are many different ways. Don't bother me and ask me how. You have to find out. We talk to different personalities. Many of them are known. Some are just people we meet downstairs and invite them up for chai. But the point is, it's fun and it's very therapeutic. So please join in and listen to Cyrus Says.